إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفوته من خلقه وحبيبه، قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وجاهد في سبيل دينه حتى أتاه اليقين. فاللهم اجزه عنا وعن والدينا وعن الإسلام والمسلمين خير ما جازيت به نبيًا عن قومه ورسولًا عن أمته. اللهم أحينا على سنته وآمتنا على ملته، واحشرنا تحت لوائه وأوردنا حوضه، واسقنا من يده الشريفة شربة هنيئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا. أما بعد، brothers and sisters, last time we started off talking about some of the signs of the day of judgment. Among the things we need to focus on is the saying of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, إِذَا وُسِّدَ الْأَمْرُ لِغَيْرِ أَهْلِهِ فَانْتَظِرِ السَّاعَةِ. If leadership positions are given to people who do not qualify, who have not got the experience, the knowledge, the taqwa, the temperament, the wisdom, and the leadership skills, then انتظر الساعة, wait for the hour. It is one of those signs of the day of judgment that we witness a day today a lot. We've seen nations led by the wrong people, and they are led into nothing but destruction, divisiveness, hatred, abuse of power, abuse of position, cronyism, all of the qualities that many nations suffer from today. It is obvious that what we have witnessed few days ago, a couple of days ago, is not news. For many people who have been observing that the guy in the White House was not going to leave without a fight, a physical fight, an armed fight, and he's proven all of those to be right. This is not a personal issue, nor is it a political issue. The issue is about the choice of our leaders, the choice of who takes office of leadership, the choice of people who are going to lead for the interests of the people vis-a-vis people who are going to lead only themselves and their country to the destruction of their past and their future. We have seen nations before who have chosen the wrong people, albeit in a democratic process, which does not necessarily undermine that the election as something wrong. The Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they also chose their own leaders. Abu Bakr was chosen, Umar was chosen, Uthman was chosen, Ali was chosen, and all of them, they had represented their communities well, internally and externally, with their friends and with their enemies. But unfortunately, when you install somebody in a seat of power that leads millions of people, they can guide them, but only like the shaitan guides people to hellfire. كتب عليه أنه من تولاه فأنه يضله ويهديه إلى سواء الجحيم. It is written, it is ordained that anyone who follows the shaitan, whether this shaitan is a human or this shaitan is a jinn, that he would mislead him and only lead him to the pit of hellfire. These are lessons that the Quran is talking to us about. the egocentric personalities, the narcissistic personalities, people who are focused on themselves and their families for life, they cannot change all of a sudden to start serving others. A person who has been raised as a king from the beginning, born with a silver spoon in his mouth or golden spoon in his hand, this cannot be entrusted to take care of others, because others have been serving him for life. He is only used to get and never give. These types of personalities are the wrong personalities to be put in any leadership position. The Quran is very clear. We know that the king that challenged Ibrahim, he started off answering Ibrahim by saying, Ana, I am, I do. Fir'aun also told his people, Ana Rabbukum al-A'la, I am your Lord the highest. All of these egocentric personalities, the Quran is telling us, they can only lead their nations to destruction, to their own fate, unnecessarily, for no gain of anybody, including the leader himself. The leaders that Islam tells us were good for their community, the Quran gave us the example of the Queen of Sheba. When challenged by the letter of Sulaiman, what does she do? She takes the letter to her commanders and she says, Inni ulqiya ilayya kitabun kareem, innahu min Sulaiman, wa innahu bismillahir rahmanir rahim, alla ta'lu alayya wa'tuni muslimin. They say, the leaders, al amru ilayk, the decision is yours, you are in charge. Fanzuri madha ta'murin, look at what decision you take. They introduced what they will do, saying, Nahnu ulu quwwatin wa uli ba'sin shadid, wal amru ilayk. So the leadership that leads by consensus, that leads by consultation, that leads through transparency, that gets and listens to the counsel of their leaders that they appoint. These are the leaders that everybody is looking for, not only Muslims, but non-Muslims, and every society is looking for those types of leadership. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us always as an ummah and as a community, as a nation, to select and elect and install only the right leaders in the right positions. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وبعد. Brothers and sisters, إذا ائتمن الخائن وخون الأمين وصدق الكاذب وكذب الصادق ووسد الأمر إلى غير أهله فانتظر الساعة. If the matters of leadership are given to disqualified people and unqualified people, wait for the hour to come. We are seeing this more often today than none. And it's coming very closer to home. Actually, it's coming very much into our home. As much as some nations have worked to destroy other nations from the outside, by divisiveness, by creating chaotic atmosphere, by bidding people against each other, Allah is testing our nation by the same diseases. The same diseases we have sown in other nations are now plaguing our own country. This is also a lesson for America, to remember that what you said in the past still stands true. What goes around comes around. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us learn lessons and learn it from the Quran so that we can manage and control our lives the way we should. Allahumma ighfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit aqdamana wa ansurna ala al-qawm al-kafirin. Allahumma ashfi mardana wa marda al-muslimin wa arham mawtana wa mawta al-muslimin wa a'li bifadlika ya rabbi kalimatay al-haq wa al-deen واجعلنا هداة مهتدين غير ضالين ولا مضلين. اللهم أحسن عاقبتنا في الأمور كلها وأجرنا من خزي الدنيا ومن عذاب الآخرة. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فستذكرون ما أقول لكم وأفوض أمري إلى الله. إن الله بصير بالعباد. وأقم الصلاة.